الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد أحبتي في الله Why should you adhere to the madhab of the Salaf? Why? We have to ask ourselves this because many people find confusion and instead they find that people and individuals and organizations and websites and forums call them to other than the Book of Allah and other than the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and other than the madhab of the Salaf, which they are called to do and which they are called to enjoin. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that we would break as an ummah, that we would divide, that we would have division, that we would have rancor, that we would have hatred, that we would fight one another and strike the necks of one another. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, افتركت اليهود على 71 فرقة وافتركت النصارى على 72 فرقة وستفترك هذه أمة على 73 فرقة كلها في النار الواحدة قلنا من هي يا رسول الله قال من كان على مثل ما كان عليه وأصحابي اليوم. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said the Jews will break into 71 sects, my Ummah in the 72 sects, the Christians in the 72 sects, my Ummah in the 73 sects, all of them in the fire except one. They said, who are they, Ya Rasulullah? He, salawatu Rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi, said, those who are upon what I'm upon and what my companions are upon. So then why, you ask, why follow the madhab of the Salaf? Why do I call myself Salafi? Is it a necessity? The ulama speak about this in depth. And of course, it's an obligation to follow the madhab of the Salaf. It's not an obligation to be Ash'ari. It's not an obligation to be Sufi. It's not an obligation to be Bareilawi. It's not an obligation to be Deobandi. It's not an obligation to be Naqshbandi. It's not an obligation to be any of the sects and groups and partisans in Jama'at, like Jama'at al-Tabliq or Jama'at al-Takfir with Hijra, with Jama'at al Ikhwan al-Muslimin, any of these groups and sects that claim Islam. It isn't that they have nothing of Islam. That's not what we say, abadan. But we say that they're not calling to the pure Islam. They're not calling to the Book of Allah, and they're not calling to the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in accordance with the madhab of the Salaf. They depart either because of politics, they depart either because of ta'wil or ta'til of the sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They depart either because their whole methodology is built upon their aql, their intellect. They depart because they call to Sufiya, they call to Tasawwuf, instead of calling to the spirituality that's intrinsic to the Madhab of the Salaf. The Madhab of the Salaf is spiritual purification. The Madhab of the Salaf is Tahara Ma'nawiyya with Tahara Hissiyya. You know, it involves the purification, self-purification, Tazkiyya to Nafs, purifying the soul. And this is a part of the madhab al-Salaf. So why is it we need to go outside or look to other traditions, other religions, other manahij to bring us closer to Allah? La, we don't have to. But this is what the people do. Instead, they say we need to dance and be like the swirling dervishes or whatever you call them, like in Turkey and other places. We need to follow that because when we spin, we become so dizzy, we become closer to Allah. We spin so much and we dance with so much joy in our heart. Of course, this has to bring us closer to Allah because we feel so good. And when we make so much dhikr, that slobber comes from our mouth, of course, this makes us feel good. And it's bringing us closer to Allah. La, that's not the madhab of Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnata khulafa rashidin al-mahdiin. It's upon you my sunnah and the sunnah of the rightly guided khulafa rashidin al-mahdiin. Meaning, what did Abu Bakr do, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu? What did Umar do, bin al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu? What did Uthman bin Affan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu do? What did Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu do? This is what we want to be upon. This is what we want to follow. And it's also not about just classifying ourselves as Salafi. It's not about a name, but rather it's about a pure tradition which goes back to the Dalil, which goes back to the Quran, which goes back to the Sunnah, which goes back to the Madhab of the Salaf and what they were united upon, and not even to individual statements of the Salaf. We don't use that as dalil. I don't say Hassan al-Basri said, so now that's the hukum shara. I don't say Ibn Mubarak said, and that's the hukum shara. I don't even say Abu Bakr or Umar said, radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, and that's the hukum shara. Khalas, intahina, la. But that has to have muwafaqa, their ijtihadat as ulama. Their striving to attain the truth and attain an Islamic ruling has to be in accordance with the Quran, and has to be in accordance with the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and it has to be in accordance with what the Salaf were united upon. This is what we're ordered to follow. We're not ordered to follow cliques and crews and groups and ahzab. And it doesn't matter if you're from Morocco. It doesn't matter if you're from France. It doesn't matter if you're from Sweden. It doesn't matter if you're from Indonesia. It doesn't matter if you're from Ethiopia. And I don't care if you're from Somalia. And I don't care if you're from America. No one has a monopoly. Nor do I care if you're from Saudi Arabia, because no one has a monopoly in Salafiyah. Salafiyah is qala Allah wa qala Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa qala sahaba. وقال الصحابة رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين. This is what the madhab of the Salaf. العبرة بحقائق ليس بمسميات. العبرة بحقائق ليس بمسميات. The reality of something is in its reality is in its substance, not in its musammiyat, not in its name. So if you call yourself Salafi, if you call yourself Ahl al-Athar, if you call yourself Ahl al-Hadith, the proof is, are you practicing what Ahl al-Hadith were upon? Are you calling to what Ahl al-Hadith called to? Are you adhering to the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam? Are you following what our Imam Muqbil bin Hadi al-Wadi'i said when he said, da'wah to Ahl al-Sunnah, da'wah to ila kitabi la wa min kitabi la ila kitabi la wa min sunnati Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ila sunnati Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is that what you're calling to? Are you calling to the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? From the Book of Allah to the Book of Allah, and from the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, meaning you're using the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as dalil. Not even the great Imam Muqbil bin Hadi al-Wadi'i, as we mentioned. That's his statement, is not dalil. But what he said has muwafaqah with the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What he said has muwafaqah with the minhaj of the Salaf. What he says is what we need to strive to be upon, and we ask Allah the Almighty to bless us with ilman nafi wa rizqan tayyib wa amalan mutaqabbilan wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.